downtown.
Okay, yeah, the downtown
strip.
Just like
right down this street here is Fourth. There's a big building that's brick.
I would just go down to the downtown area.
It's called Huber.
See, we're getting ready for the big trip.
Miss Field, would you please get us some wine? Yes, I've been trying to remember everything I'll need for the trip and William's wedding, as well as trying to decide which trunk I should take.
There should be no question as to the trunk, Thomas. You must take the larger one, so as to bring back purchases from America. You'll need the room.
And what would I bring back in my trunk?
Perhaps Niagara.
Purses from America? Things aren't much to find there. I'd rather have English things. Is there anything else?
You might want to make a point of seeing Indians while you're in America, Thomas.
I'm afraid I have no interest in Indians.
Here's a mask and altar stone. Now you'll be able to celebrate Mass while you're on.
Thank you. I'll be sure to return it safely.
I had a thought.
And what would that be?
That you may not wish to return to us. That you may enjoy living among your Catholic relatives in America. You and your brother William are the only two Catholics in your family.
Me? Live in America?
Yes, you might find a position there. You might find a school that would need a scholar like yourself. Your life here is one of poverty, and your parishioners are mostly peasants.
I cannot say that I haven't thought of such things, but no. I'll not abandon my home. These are the people Christ has entrusted to me. Please have a seat. Here you are! Thank you.
Great.
I can't tell you how much this intrigues me. To think of such a ship is utterly fascinating.
Well, I've been reading all about Titanic. Do you know they say she's unsinkable?
Unsinkable? How can a ship be unsinkable?
She's almost 1,000 feet long. It's outfitted with the very latest in safety features, including a double hull. She also has many more lifeboats than are required by law, but they say Titanic does not need them.
Because she is unsinkable?
They say she's a magnificent vessel, a regular floating city. I do envy you.
I shall take my umbrella.
I have thought about the weather at this time of the year. It is only the middle of April, and there are always icebergs on the North Atlantic at this time.
Oh, I'm sure they'll stay clear of icebergs.
Let us both hope so. Well, I suppose I'll be off. May your journey be safe. Goodbye and Godspeed, my friend.
Goodbye, Edward.
I hope you'll come back.
Maiden Voyage! She's certainly the grandest ship I've ever seen!
A fine ship indeed!
Third class passenger, please proceed to the gangway! Please have your boarding documents and await your instructions! Look at her! Look at her!
She's grand, isn't she? Grand!
She's a miracle!
All our children and our children's children will know that we took this trip for them.
God be praised! We have indeed!
1,700
quarts
ice cream, Titanic.
Second class, Gatlinburg, please proceed to your proper decks and wait for your dining assignments.
So this is the famous Titanic. My friend Monsignor Watson himself cannot imagine such a vessel.
First class, passengers, you may now proceed to your seats. Miss Edith Corson, Evans Cabin, A29.
Margaret? Margaret Brown?
Miss Evans, how are you? Are you traveling on Titanic as well?
Yes. Isn't that exciting?
Dear, I'm just looking forward to getting home.
This ship is the finest in the world.
1,500 gallons fresh milk, Titanic.
Can you believe it? Us on a splendid ship?
31,000 bottles of wine, beer, and spirits. Titanic!
A ship? It looks more like a mountain than a ship, Maddie.
Margaret, it looks long on someone to walk to America.
36,000 oranges, Titanic.
Oh, but she is splendid, isn't she? Kate, who believe we'd be traveling in such style?
Well, we deserve it, you know. We're going to be ladies' maid. Have to get used to such style.
16,000 lemons, Titanic.
Left at Liverpool Street. Your
arrived at Southampton, the boat train, at 11:30 and started at 12 o'clock very punctually. At 1 we had lunch. We were then still on Southampton water, but when we came out of lunch, we were between Portsmouth and the Isle of Wight. Before coming out of summer, we had stopped at Cherbourg, and the tender was just coming alongside with passengers. The tender is a good-sized boat of 1,260 tons, but by the side of Titanic, she looks as though with a good crane, we could lift her out of the water and lay her on deck without feeling any inconvenience. When you look down the water from the top deck, it is like looking from the roof of a very high building. At the time of writing, 7:45, we are still stopping at Cherbourg. The English Channel was decidedly rough to look at, but we felt it no more in the roughest part than when we were in Southampton water. I do not much like the throbbing of the screws, but that is the only motion we feel. I shall not be able to say mass tomorrow morning, as we shall just be arriving at Queenstown. I'll write as soon as I get to New York. Yes, that'll do nicely.
Thank you.
St. Patrick, you'll be catching a death of cold if you don't.
Aye, and do you think we've slowed down at all?
Slowing down? I think we're going as fast as we've ever been since we've been on this trip.
We'll be all right, Kate. This is Titanic.
It's getting cold.
It is. It has to be below freezing.
With no moon and no wind, we won't be able to see much out there tonight. There isn't even a wave or a swell that can help us fight an iceberg.
I'm going inside. You coming with me?
Aye.
Well, I'm sure we wouldn't be going this fast if there was danger. I hope you're right. We must have hung at least 21 knots. I could talk among the crew that this speed is ideal for Mr. Monk's Ismay.
He told us to consider himself nothing more than a passenger. Now he's giving us orders in regards to speed. We shouldn't be going this fast on a maiden voyage. And this water, it's as smooth and as flat as a mill pond.
As I said, it won't be easy to spot anything out there tonight. Do you know they don't even have binoculars in the crow's nest?
Yes, you can see better with your eyes, but you'll be all right. Just keep a good lookout.
I'll be off. I have to be getting up to the crow's nest.
I'll see you later. I'm on duty as well. I'm in charge of it tonight.
Lucky us.
Hurry
this way!
chance to make it better for ourselves in America.
Please, let's have order here. Women and children only.
What will become of us?
Hurry, this way. Please, right this way.
I only wanted to be a lady's maid, that's all.
Please, we must trust in God.
If only the Californian had come to our aid. Why didn't they answer our distress signals?
Has God abandoned us, Father?
No, he has not. We must trust in him alone.
But Father, the lifeboats are filling up and there is no room for us.
I know, my child. Let us pray for his help.
If only I had not tried to go around the iceberg.
Look, there's only one more boat. Why has this happened?
We do not always understand why things happen. God asks only that we remain faithful to him. Let us trust him.
If only we had been going slower.
Thank you.
Yeah, go back.